Welcome back to this commitment edition of KATV News Watch 7's Chronicle. This morning, we're taking a closer look at the race for Douglas County Sheriff. Aaron Hansen is on the Republican ballot. He's an Omaha native, spent nearly 25 years with the Omaha Police Department. Hansen's also served as president of the Omaha Police Officers Association. KATV News Watch 7's David Earle spoke with Hansen about his motivation for running.
It comes down to three things. I mean, we have to keep people safe in Douglas County. That always has to be the priority. Whether we're talking about running the sheriff's office or policy decisions from county government, the priority has to be keeping innocent families safe. Number two, knowing what an important relationship that our law enforcement community has with the public, we have to make sure that we have good and honest police professionals' backs. That means treating them fairly, treating them with respect, and making sure that they can raise their family in dignity. And ultimately, that will give us that trust in return, where I think that increases the relationship that the law enforcement has with the community. And number three, if we truly hope to finally get long-term public safety gains in the long run, we have to have credible messengers like me to advocate for giving worthy people a second chance, helping people to break cycles of poverty, create generational wealth anew, and help people to raise their families in dignity. That ultimately will stop crime trends.
What's your plan to recruit and retain deputies if you're elected?
Sure. Well, number one, I'm going to have to really work hard to change the culture of the sheriff's office. I need to make the sheriff's office, Douglas County Sheriff's Office, a destination employment location. I'd like to see where eventually we start to hire away officers from maybe agencies like the Omaha Police Department even, or Nebraska State Patrol, or especially agencies from Minnesota or maybe California that do not value their police professionals as much as we do in Nebraska and in Douglas County and Omaha. That's gonna require a few things. Again, culture change, increasing morale. We're gonna have to make sure they're being paid a wage and benefit structure that's comparable with the working conditions and the risks that they face. But also, we're going to have to look at more non-traditional methods of recruitment, making sure that we're appealing to a diverse group of officers, whether they be new recruits or seasoned officers in other communities. Right now, we were working hard in Lincoln with sheriffs and chiefs across the state to make it easier to transfer a law enforcement license, a law enforcement certificate, from one state to another. Those are the type of innovative ideas that will ultimately make it easier to recruit and retain great deputies in Douglas County.
You know, transparency has been a big topic in law enforcement over the past couple of years. How would you apply, how do you view transparency in law enforcement, and then how would you apply transparency if elected sheriff?
You know, I think that's one of the most unique aspects of the position of sheriff. You are the lawman or lawwoman of the people. And if the people don't like the job that you do, if they don't trust you, if they don't think you communicate enough, or if they don't think you're transparent enough, they're gonna fire you in 4 years. So I think that the ballot box alone is a great way to make sure that the people know that the chief law enforcement executive for the sheriff's office must be participative, communicative, and transparent. We also have to always keep in mind that our police professionals, our deputies, they have a very difficult job, and their employees as well. I don't care what workforce you're at, employees, they demand not only respect, but it's incumbent that we give them privacy as well in their personnel files. But I think you can find that good balance with good, honest communication with the public. Explain to people what we do and why we do it. And when you do have a flashpoint situation, be honest about it. I'm gonna follow Chief Schmatter's lead. You will probably be you'll see a similar approach to dealing with public issues from Sheriff Hansen as you do with Chief Schmatter. I've learned a lot from him.
Also on the Republican ticket, George Merrithew. He is currently a private practice attorney from Grand Island. He graduated from Hastings College and Creighton Law School. Matthew spent 25 years with the Omaha Police Department, retiring as a lieutenant. He's also spent 38 years with the U.S. Army Reserves. I sat down with Matthew to get the priorities of his campaign.
I want to make sure we're spending money the right way. I'm not scared to spend money because we need to spend money. The police department has to be fully funded. It needs to be there. We need to make sure that the salaries for deputies is commensurate with the metropolitan area. Right now we're losing deputies at Douglas County to other agencies because the pay isn't quite the same. And whether it needs to be exactly the same as Omaha's or very close to it, needs to be better than it is right now. So that's one area I want to look at. I want to look at some other areas, and you need to get into the department to fully analyze it. So I want to get in there and see if there's some savings that can be done. I want to make sure that we're not duplicating services. I want to make sure that we're not spending money in areas that aren't best practices and are the best way and most efficient way to spend our money. I want to look at some public-private partnerships to work on some expansion. Douglas County Sheriff's Department needs their own firing range. They need their own gun range, and that's something I want to look at. But I want to look at that in possibly a partnership with a private range and see if we can work something out to where we have access to a range that a private organization is running. I'd also like to get into some more serious talks with the surrounding communities other than Omaha on the, as you know, they recently got approved a basic course where when there's enough students in the metro area, the other law enforcement agencies, Sarpy County, Bellevue, La Vista and Papillion, we can get together and have our own academy. Well, with the state changing the laws and requiring double the amount of continuing education now, it makes sense for us to try and create a little bit more of a permanent area so that we're not having to borrow conference rooms at different police stations and police headquarters and trying to run it out of a conference room. We have a more professional classroom setup. And that's something that I want to enter into with them and try and work on that.
About transparency, how do you make the department more transparent, and how transparent should it be? What should the public know?
Well, first of all, body-worn cameras are huge for transparency. Not only do they let the public know what's going on, and they give an unvarnished view, now they don't always give the true story, because a camera mounted on your chest or mounted on your shoulder or even the glasses, not too many people like those, but mounted anywhere, it's only giving one small view. And it's you need to be able to explain what else is going on around there. For example, it's only got so big a field of vision. What's the officer seeing out of the corner of his eye over here? What else is going on? How many people are behind him? How many people are on the other way? So the body-worn camera, while it gives a clear picture and a factual picture of what's going there, it doesn't always tell the whole story. But at least it gives you a starting point, and it gives you something that the public can see and understand. Now, whether we release it, which we're not required to, we release it or we release snapshots, we at least have the ability to show what the officer is perceiving directly in front of him. I would be more for a structured release of video, and that's within the authority of a chief or a sheriff. They certainly can do that.
Current assessment of the sheriff's department?
It's full of really good officers. I think you don't hear a lot about deputies creating problems or there being an issue with deputies, and I like that. I think it's fairly open. I think there are some areas that can be improved on, but not so much with the deputies, more in the management style and how things are being done. And the benefits have to be better for the deputies. And I mean that as training, compensation, retirement. It has to be on par with the rest of the metro community.
And that's how you recruit more and retain more?
Absolutely. Recruiting is a huge challenge for all law enforcement right now. 2021 did no favors to law enforcement and forced a lot of people, not really forced, but myself included, we retired because we could, and it was getting ugly. So it's gotten better, and the beauty of it is Omaha, Douglas County, we support our law enforcement, and the citizens support our law enforcement.
All right, still to come, another Douglas County race. Two Democrats are on the ballot for clerk of the district court. Their message to voters coming up. First, a reminder, your comments are an important part of the show. What do you want to see from the next sheriff? Email us, news@ketv.com. We'll be right back.